tonight on the news. Later on, we'll have an interview with comedy co-creator Kyle DeWeese. Is going to tell you about a lot of the stuff coming up this year at the Comedy Mosh Pit. We'll also discuss things about graham crackers weighing more than they should, onomatopoeia not sounding like what it is, and men who cry during sex. Also, I'm really, really sorry, Rebecca. But first off, a few words from our sponsors. Tonight, we want to thank our sponsors. Be Here Now, one of the greatest comedy locations ever. We also got to thank our traditional sponsor, Gay Bacon. Gay Bacon. It both snaps and sizzles. Tonight's show also brought to you by Sega. Sega! This message approved by Sega. And now on to today's news. First, we'll start off with entertainment news. 80s rock mega group Journey watched their first episode of Glee later last week. Journey has now finally stopped believing. In other news, porn star Jenna Jameson was pulled over and given a DUI, which is fucking hilarious. How does much does that have to hurt her ego to get pulled over by a cop and she's like, you know why I pulled you over? Well, I've had a few to drink. Well, I'm gonna have to arrest you. Is there anything I could do to change your mind? No, you're old now. And I will say this, traditionally, in terms of porn, I don't really like Jenna Jameson sort of girls. Big, busty, blonde, stupid girls. No offense to all of you here, but I will say, of her work, though, if anyone has ever seen her porn remake of A Notebook, it is moving. Really a tearjerker. Anyway, in other news, this actually happened. I'm not making up any of this news. I did this research all week. Kanye West's apartment was broken into, which is hilarious. I love that idea that he was broken into. Supposedly, the only thing they took is some lyrics for a song he's planning on to release later this year. So luckily, like, nothing of value was taken. But I love the fact that, I just like the idea that maybe he saw the person taking stuff out in a bag, and he's like, hang on. I'm going to let you finish. But never mind. Way too old of a reference, everybody. Did anyone actually hear about the thing that happened to LL Cool J? Which is oddly relevant. Okay, this happened last night, also not making this up. LL Cool J's house was also broken into. He caught the man in the act and beat the shit out of him. Yes, I think that's so awesome. Just like somebody breaking in and then just seeing LL Cool J, who only works out when he's not recording music, and he's not recorded music for a while. Like, he's fucking jacked up. The police asked him why did he beat this man into like a living pulp, and he said, he ate my bird. Okay, for those of you who haven't seen Deep Blue Sea, Mama said knock you out. Damn it, LL Cool J is not relevant pop culture-wise because nobody knows who the hell he is. That sucks. And tragic news today, Justin Bieber is still alive.
Damn it!
A nation mourns. Before we go any further, we got to thank tonight's sponsors. Johnson & Johnson foreskin removal. For a little while, I was concerned that my foreskin was getting too big. It almost had become a five skin. Then I discovered Johnson & Johnson foreskin removal. I know what you're thinking, guys. Is it expensive? No, they work for just the tip. Tonight's show also brought to you by Gay Bacon. It goes straight to your ass. Now back to the news. Since we are in Indiana, we are going to do the local meth news. This is true. So a man was arrested for having a meth lab that he had created in a Walmart bathroom, which saddens me and should sadden all of you that Walmart is moving in on the small meth makers of America. Releasing their own thing. Has anyone here heard about Walter White?
Yeah.
Okay. There's an actual man named Walter White, which is the same name as the character in Breaking Bad, the same name as the lead character. And 2 weeks ago, he was arrested for selling meth. Yeah. To that man. And, no, that is an insane thing for me. Not the fact that there's somebody else named Walter White. That's not crazy. That's not weird. There's a lot of people with a lot of different names. The crazy thing is that somebody would buy meth from him. How do you not see that as an undercover cop? Like, who do do you get your weed from? Oh, this guy named Cheech and Chong. Like, it's fucking, it sounds so made up. Let's see what else we got here. In science news, scientists have discovered that Parkinson's really just a permanent case of jazz hands. If that offends any of you, imagine a grandmother with a tambourine and a maraca. Yeah, she's got a beat because of the Parkinson's. And in other news, I am not a homosexual. No matter what you write on the dirt in the window of the back of my car, Dad. Comedy Moshpit News looks to appeal to both genders. Tonight, I am featuring women's news. First off, a quick poll. A new stereotype has emerged amongst women that women are bad at video games. I don't personally agree with it. Round of applause if you think girls are good at video games. We recently polled our audience and discovered that nearly 50% of you think that women are okay at video games. That's good. I will say personally, my girlfriend is fantastic, or at least her boobs are great at playing Fallout. Anyway. And in men's news, Prince Charles of England renamed his penis Buckingham Phallus. On next week's men's news, duct tape on balls, the pros and cons. The list will not surprise you. Gonna stop and thank tonight's sponsor, Outback Steakhouse. You know how bad Anne Frank's life was? That's how good our steaks are. Also, we gotta thank our sponsor, Gay Bacon. You like BLT sandwiches? Try a GLBT sandwich. I don't personally care for it, but I tried it once in college. Also brought to you by RyanMastComedy.com. Log on with your log out. Before I go any further, gotta go over to our book corner, which is just right, that's like 1 inch over. This week I'm reviewing the book, second edition, Babies with Down Syndrome. I bought this because I was like, what the fuck? It's got like cartoons, like it's a kid's storybook. And I read this book cover to cover, and this is all I can say. It's a little slow. Well, before I go any further, tonight we want to bring up our guest, Kyle Lewis. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this, they have pictures in this, which is ridiculous because they all look alike. All right. Kyle, tell us a little bit about what's going to happen at the Comedy Mosh Pit the rest of this year.
If you can excuse me, I've got the sound amplification problem taken care of.
Oh, the man with the horrible timing's going to help you? Good.
All right, how we doing tonight? Woo! For the rest of the year, here's what we got going on. Next week, we're doing a noob contest. It's for first-timers to stand-up comedy only. If you think you're funny, you can actually win $100. Who's interested in that? Like 5 people. Fuck yeah! It's going to be a great show.
Rousing support.
Then on September 19th, we've got the Comedy Mosh Pit's 100th show. We've got headliner Scott Long coming out. The guy's written for Fox NFL Sunday. He's been on ESPN, NBC, all sorts of shit like that. The dude is fucking awesome. Come out and see him on September 19th. And then starting on October, I don't remember the date is, 3rd, we have the 3rd annual Indiana's King of Comedy Contest. Woo! Yeah! We're going to do that again this year. Winner of it gets $500. And that's it.
Oh, okay. Also, he's getting married in like 2 weeks. That's clown jizz, everyone. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the first edition of Comedy Mosh Pit News. What'd you think? I've been Ryan Mast, and you've been entertained. Thank you so much.